I've left my own hobby horse to last. Grammar, of course, is about the way in which sentences are structured. The lexicon, well, that was right at the beginning. It was in the words section, and it's about words and dictionaries and the mental lexicon, the dictionary of the words in your head. Well, the lexicon also contains grammar. It contains grammatical constructions. We memorize huge amounts of syntax. We remember whole phrases. It's reputed that Winston Churchill remembered huge long poems off by heart. We can all remember stuff off by heart. Well, where is that? Well, some of it anyway is in the lexicon because we use it to build sentences. We don't just build sentences out of words. We also build sentences out of phrases which we have already stored, ready for use in our mental lexicon. And we can call this the phrasal lexicon, that bit of our mental dictionary that contains phrases as opposed to words. And the mental dictionary contains huge numbers of these phrases. One estimate is that for every single word you know, you probably know 10 phrases which contains that word. 10 phrases for every word. Let's suppose, as I said at the beginning, that you have, 50,000 words in your mental dictionary. Well, if you know 10 phrases with that word in it, that makes 500,000 phrases. We can do a little experiment. Pick a verb like pick. How many phrases do you know with the verb pick in? To pick winners, to pick a team, etc. There are plenty of them. Take verbs like take advantage of, take notice of, take care of, take cognizance of, take advice from. There are hundreds of expressions we know with the verb to take. Well, sometimes these are called cliches, and that's given them a bad press. A cliche is just a phrasal lexical item that someone recognizes as being, if you like, overused. But listen to the news sometime. Television news readers use cliches all the time. On election night, after an election, every sentence contains cliches of some sort. Election cliches. One of the cliches that the news has is all the news that's fit to print. Newspaper people know about that. It's an interesting question. What is fit to print? There are idioms. Idioms are non-compositional phrases. We talked about compositionality earlier and said that one of the things that happens is people can make up the meanings of the whole out of the meanings of the parts. And that's true of the meanings of phrases. But idioms, they don't allow that. For example, when we say that we're chewing the fat, we're not really chewing the fat. We're not chewing at all. And it's got nothing to do with fat. It means we're talking, chewing the fat. It's an idiom. There are hundreds and hundreds of thousands of idioms around. There are formulae. Formulae are phrases we use for particular purposes. So we come to the checkout, and the checkout operator says, "How are you today?" They don't say, "How are you today?" They say, "How are you today?" That's what they say. And when you leave, what do they say? Have a good day. These are formulae. They're used for particular purposes. What do we say when we've stepped on someone's toe? We say, "I'm sorry." Well, we didn't make that up. We don't say, "I do think badly of myself for having stood on your toe." That's not what we say. That's in for a dig. We just don't say that. And in for a dig is a formula. There are proverbs. There's many a slip 'twixt a cup and a lip, whatever that means. There are hundreds and hundreds of proverbs. The phrasal lexicon is very important in speech. It's very important in particular circumstances. For example, you can't be a racing commentator of horse races without having a huge phrasal lexicon full of expressions that are useful for horse racing. You can't sell at auction without being very adept at pulling stuff out of your phrasal lexicon. All of you, as you learn more about linguistics, will get to know its phrasal lexicon, because there is a phrasal lexicon for every subject. And if I'm right that the phrasal lexicon is 10 times the size of the ordinary lexicon, then you probably do have 500,000 phrases stored in your head. Well, 500,000's quite a lot, isn't it? Aren't we clever? Here's something you could do when you've got nothing better to do sometime. Think of the number of hours you've been awake in the whole of your lifetime. Let's suppose that you have 500,000 phrases in your mental dictionary. How many of those have you learnt per hour? It's a considerable achievement.